Right now, this is Future. You watching Hip Hop at Lunch, and we at lunch. We eating right now. Big ups to Hip Hop at Lunch, man. I see y'all. Double salute. This is Future. We at Pluto.
This is Mike Boyd, Hip Hop at Lunch, here with Future. How's it going, man?
Man, it's going great.
Yeah.
Can't complain. I can't complain.
MTV Fab Five, SOBs headlining, man.
MTV Fab Five, SOBs, Club Perfection, Hip Hop at Lunch, what it do, we here.
And
my whole support team, you know what I'm saying? Y'all play a big, major role in it every day on Twitter, just bigging me up. Any mixtape I drop, any single I drop, if I drop a song, y'all leak it out, y'all be the first ones to talk about it, tweet about it. And that's real big, man. I appreciate y'all's support, you know what I mean?
All day,
I
got to say that. So Streetz Calling, September 11th. It's your first tape with DJ Drama, man. I want to know, like, what you trying to do with this. I know a lot of people are watching you right now.
I just want to set a, just keep the fire to the streets, like, add more fire to the flame. And just, you know what I mean? Keep the anticipation up, keep the momentum going. So I just dropped a lot of street records. It wasn't really about hits. It's, they say it's some hits on there, but I wasn't really trying to focus on the hit. I'm just trying to focus on Tony Montana and Magic, making sure those top the charts. And then, just keep the fire to the flame. That's why I want to do 9/11 Streetz Calling, 911 Streetz Calling. Just keep that fire to the flame, like I said. You know what I mean?
Yeah, man, you've been grinding this year alone, man. Dirty Sprite, True Story, Free Bricks. You've just been going in. I wanted to talk a little bit about Pluto, because I know the fans have been waiting on that. Like, what you going to do with Pluto, and what's that mean to you, man?
Pluto is just like bridging the gap from when I first started to now. It's just like I'm bringing every element to the game, just taking it to the next level too. Like, just showing I can make different music, but at the same time, I can make street music, but I'm making different kind of songs, like these songs on, like The Truth Gonna Hurt, just songs on, just stick out of my head, Go Harder, Motion Picture, just little songs like that stick out of my head for Pluto. They different songs that the streets are not even used to, but it's just like building up. It's like a building process, preparing them for what's about to happen on Pluto, so I gotta keep the streets enthused, you know what I mean?
Definitely. And the video for Ain't No Way Around It, I know that's coming up, but I want to talk, like, what's it like working with Mike Will Made It? I know you guys done a bunch of tracks, and Dirty Sprite, Turn It Up, he was on all over Free Bricks. Like, what's it like working with him, man?
Man, Mike is a cool dude, you know, like, man, it's like, we like family at the end of the day. He stay at the studio, whether I'm working on another producer beat, or I'm working on his beat, he's still there just telling me, go in. I know he be telling me to go in so I can get around to his beats. But at the end of the day, he keep pushing me. He always stay pushing me. And so that's positive, just keeping that positive energy around me. So Mike, he always in the studio with me. So that's why you might just hit me on some of his beats, because when I finish a beat, he gonna make sure he pull his beat up. And then he be having some hot shit, though. Like, Mike got that. Mike got heat, you know what I mean? Mike will. Like, so, man, at the end of the day, man, me and him homies. So it always work out when I get a chance to rap on one of my homeboys' music, and he got the potential to take it to the next level, and we have some of the same potentials to becoming superstars in the next generation. So just to work with him and knowing his potential, it feels good. You know, we both taking off pretty much at the same time.
Yeah, I mean, every time you guys collab, it comes out great, man.
Every time, just for some reason, every time we do something, they come out great. And I believe because of me and him, he have a major role, because, like I said, he pushed me to the limit, and he always hearing what he want on his beats, and he right there with me. It's just like some producers send you their beat, so they can't really tell you what they like on their beat. So if he hears something come out my mouth, because I freestyle everything, so if he hear, he like, bro, that's it, go and say that. Man, honestly, I might be like, for real, like, ain't nowhere around it. When I did Ain't Nowhere Around It, I just went in the booth and said it, and I was like, man, it's all right. And I ain't even do no verses to it. He was like, bro, that Ain't Nowhere Around It is a smash. Do that. So I just kept going back to the studio, and then I just jumped on it. You know what I'm saying? DJ Spins, that's my partner,
right,
too. So he been in the studio with me, too. So even though he didn't produce the record, he told me, like, when I did the verse to Ain't No Way Around, he was like, man, you need to rap the second verse the same way. That shit crazy. That's going to be big when it's coming out. So DJ Spin, like, he play a major role in everything I have going on, too. Like, that's like my A&R.
Yeah. And shout out to Spins and everyone at Hood Rich, man.
Everybody at Hood Rich, you know, they support me from day one. My homie Rip, you know, this is my family. Like, from the beginning, they always been around. Just telling me to keep going, man. Don't stop. Even when I wanted to stop, it was just like, you got the talent, just the timing and everything. You really can't see it when you 2 years away. you can't see where you're going to be at 2 years from then. You know what I mean? Like, just now, from 5 years from now, you know where you want to be, but you can't say, okay, I'm going to be on the G4. You know you want to be there, but the feeling is different when you get there.
So Geeked Out of My Mind with Trouble, you killed your verse on that, man. Geeked Up to the Moon, Young Future, yeah. Just Call Me NASA. Had that on repeat for a while, man. I want to know, like, what's it like working with Trouble?
Line. People don't catch those lines because, you know, they say we're from Atlanta, so we can't get those metaphors and those good punchlines. But at the end of the day, you listen to the music, I be telling them it's like a message, and it's punchline for punchline all through the verses.
Definitely.
So, man, shout out to Trouble. You know, that's my family, too. Trouble, DTE, you know, Black, who signed him, that's my brother. You know what I mean? Like, off camera, me and him, every day we together, just riding around, like, early in the morning. If I need advice, I might talk to him way before I even came out, before I even did Racks. Me and Black hang together every day. He the one who believed in me before I even believed in myself. Tell you the truth, he always tell me, man, you got it. Just stay here to stay. I be like, man, I'm ready to stop. He like, man, keep going. So, Black, I salute him, and I see how he worked with Trouble. Like, Black, man, he a good dude at the end of the day. So, man, salute Duct Tape on everything they got going on. That's my family.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Big Bank Black, man.
Yeah, Big Bank, man. That's my brother.
So I know you released a few personal tracks, Long Time Coming, For My People, Much More. I wanted to know, like, what was the motivation behind Long Time Coming, man?
A Long Time Coming, it was just like, man, everything was going on, the success with Race, the success with Tony Montana. I had then True Story. Then it was just this girl that stuck out of my head, that one of my past relationships, and she wanted to see this more than I wanted to see, but she ain't experiencing what I'm going through right now because I don't mess with her no more. But at the same time, when I first started rapping, she was a part of everything. And right now, she ain't a part of it. I just tell her, like, it's been a long time coming. You know what I'm saying? Like, on every verse, really dedicated to her, like, from the beginning to the end. Like, I told her I even told her this on the phone one time, like, man, when I'm in Vegas, I'm going to be thinking about you. You know what I'm saying? And then the verse, I got a chance to even put in my verse, like, I was hanging out the limo, and I really was in Vegas thinking about hanging out the limo, you know what I mean? So I got a chance to put that in the verse. She was like, well, just keep thinking about me. She's so arrogant. But at the same time, it's just been a long time coming. Like, real talk, True Story. Everything on True Story is True Story. Like, you know what I mean? So that's what we got to stress that. And everything is fat.
What's up, man? So before we go, Greatest Show on Earth and Upper Echelon are two of my favorite tracks, but for anyone, like, new to your music, like, what three songs would you suggest they check out to get a good feel for you, man?
For my people, off Dirty Sprite. For No Mercy, off my No Mercy mixtape, called The Code of Honor. The Code of Honor, and for my people, and make sure you check out that Tony. If you haven't listened to it all the way through, make sure you listen to it thoroughly from the first verse to the third verse.